I have been working on a new game prototype. The idea was to keep it very simple so that I could finish it within a reasonable time frame, since I don't want to just make the game, but the engine for it as well. So the idea was to come up with one mechanic, one feature, and that's the game. And the mechanic I chose was dodge. You use your mouse to collect objects on the screen while dodging obstacles, projectiles, anything. The collectibles were not part of the initial idea, but we're gonna get to that later. The first concept was that there are projectiles flying across the screen and you have to dodge them. And I wanted to keep the art style very simple, since I also had to write the engine for it. So I decided to only use two colors, one for the background and one for the entities of the game. And the idea was, you as the player are a circle and have to dodge triangles. And using these different shapes would keep the game readable despite only having two colors. Back then, I wasn't really decided if the player is controlled by mouse or by keyboard. I decided to go with mouse controls because I think that gives you much better control over the player, and you're already used to the sensitivity and movement of your mouse, opposed to using a keyboard where I would have to define how the player is moving and decide stuff like, is there any damping on the movement or is it maybe even physical based? I shortly even considered to support both options, like maybe it's different in different levels and that gives you a lot of variety. But that kind of scope creep was exactly the thing I was trying to avoid by only having one mechanic. So I started by rendering and controlling the player. Rendering the player means drawing a circle, and a circle is defined by a position and a radius. But when I want to render that circle, I have to convert the position and radius to relative values, since in OpenGL the bottom left corner is -1, -1, and the top right corner is 1, 1. And since the screen isn't quadratic, it means the relative radius of a circle is different on the x and y axis. So I'm converting the position and radius from game coordinates to screen coordinates. The game coordinates I made up go from 0, 0 in the bottom left corner to full HD in the top right corner. So when I say the radius of the player is 20 pixels, it's relative to the game coordinate system. I thought about what I would do if the aspect ratio of the window differs from the game aspect ratio, and I came to the conclusion that would be preferable to preserve the aspect ratio. I imagine the game would play very differently on a wide screen opposed to an almost quadratic one. With the player done, I wanted to try and test avoiding blocked out regions of the screen. And I wanted to start simple with rectangles instead of triangles. And so I tested the collision detection with one rectangle. But then I started to think maybe it would be cool if there were certain patterns that would block out fixed regions of the screen. Like, maybe it would start animating in from the left, covering half of the screen, then animate out towards the center, then wait for half a second, and then animate in from the center to the right. So basically the player had to move from the right side of the screen to the left side of the screen in this half second. And I thought maybe there could be more of these patterns, and maybe they could be randomly chosen, and maybe animate them a little bit, and write a nice shader to make them look cooler. And then I realized again, hold on, this wasn't the plan, so I scratched all of that. But it got me thinking about the projectiles I had originally planned. And I realized I don't really have to make projectiles that fly across the screen. I can realize that one mechanic with these rectangles I already have. And I shouldn't implement handcrafted patterns and instead focus on an algorithmic solution. So I made that really simple and just spawned rectangles randomly on the screen in a certain time interval. And I faded in the colors so the player can anticipate them, and I scaled them to 0 when they disappear. And when I tested this, it worked pretty well. The screen was filling up with always changing blocked out regions where you couldn't move to. Not the prettiest solution, but it did exactly what it was supposed to do. I quickly realized though that there was still something missing. I was always at the same spot and waited for a rectangle to show up, and then I would move out of the way. But there wasn't really a reason to move around the entire screen. It was either wait for the next rectangle to show up or move slightly out of the way. So I added collectibles you could pick up. I had the idea for collectibles before, but I put it on the ideas list because I didn't want to add another feature. But now that I played it and the minimum of everything was done, I decided to add it in a very basic form. Now there are always 4 collectibles on the screen you can pick up, and every time the player collects one, a new one spawns. So that is the current state of the prototype. The question now becomes where to go from here. Do I leave it at that, move on to another project? Do I now add some more features like the projectiles or the handcrafted patterns or the fancy shaders and animations? Or do I add a menu where you can actually see the amount of points you collected and adjust the game settings and make this like an actual complete game? I am not sure yet, but I made this video to document what I have done so far, and I hope you enjoyed it. So thank you for watching and see you next time.